Okay, I'm jumping right back into it. As soon as the last episode ended, I just hit record again. So we just researched detective. So now I can make a detective game. E for everyone. We'll call it, let's see. Sherlock Going Home. Holmes. And like it, E for everyone. Detective. RPG. We'll try that again. And we'll put it on the FX32 engine. Okay. Casual games. Okay, I'll have to research that later, I guess. Slowly losing market share against other PC manufacturers. In an unofficial statement, the G64 employee said that the company has been unsuccessful in introducing higher-priced computers to compete against newer and more advanced PCs. Turn that down. World design, graphics, and sound. Yeah, okay. I'm not really 100% sure. He's scratching his head at graphics. Get back to work. Come on. Right, get rid of those bugs. Okay, so Nintendo's introducing the Game Boy Color. Or maybe it's just the Game Boy. Underpowered, but has a lower cost and portability. Okay, we'll see. Next month. Okay, well, I may end up going into that. We'll see. Okay. Leveled up some more. Awesome. Simple cutscenes, level editor, and open world. Ugh, I gotta research so much stuff. The first reviews for Sherlock Going Holmes. It came in. I see tens. Yes! Yeah! Yeah! Yes! Hell yeah, I'm getting way too excited for this. Yes! One more 10. Come on, straight tens, baby! Ah! Wow! Yeah! Hell yeah! Oh god, 208 cat. We have 208,000. Wait and watch and see what happens here. Oh god, that is sick. I'm gonna research all of this stuff now while that's coming, while I'm waiting on that. Look at all of the. Oh my god! Holy crap! Oh my god! Woo! You've made quite a name for yourself and have saved up a lot of capital. If you want to grow the company further, then moving into a new office is the next step. Oh yeah, hell yeah. I mean, I've got. That's only 100. Yeah, god. Totally. You can also hire staff and forge a world-class development team to make even better games. You may also train yourself and your staff to improve skills. Let's try this by completing a management course, which is required before you can hire your first employee. To get started, close this message and click on your character to bring up the training menu. Okay, well, I gotta let him finish this first. Oh my god, I just made so much money. Oh, I hit that one out of the park. Train. Staff management. Game dev, gyms, don't repeat yourself. Book study. Okay, well, we need to do staff management. I'm gonna hire somebody. Today, the new game platform. Okay, the game one came out. Oh my god. 300,000 units sold. That's insane. can hear the hype. Okay. Set an advertising budget and decide how you want to test your applicants. A high budget will increase the number of applicants, and the different tests will help find people with the right balance and design for technology and skills. Let's just make the budget. I have so much money. Let's make it 200,000. Complex algorithms, a game demo, or showreel. Let's do complex algorithms. I'll put it at 150. I'll leave it at 200, I guess. I've already made it back. I can't believe they didn't have a proper office till now. I'm really looking forward to their future games. The open position is complete. You can now review the list of applicants and hire someone. Okay. You can always train your employees to improve their skills. 9,000 a month. She's level 1. Design 74. Technology 125. Juanita. 198, 284. I like this guy. His design's not high, but his technology is great. So I can always train him, right? So I'm gonna do that. To give your new staff a welcome training to get them up to speed quickly. Okay. How do I do... Here we go. Train. Welcome training. Boom. I need to get him up on design, too, I think. 356,000 units generating 2.4 million in sales. Oh my god, that's insane. Research. Open world, level editor, casual games, new topics. Oh god, there's so much I need to do. Let's do medium games. Okay. Okay. Don't overwhelm them with too many sessions. Okay, got it. Let's create game report training. I can have him research something, can I? Okay, cool. Here, you can research casual games for me. Or no, can you not? No? I don't think you can. No, okay. Well, what can you do? Okay, I can't do anything with him right now, so I'm just going to wait. Marketing. I cannot... Is it because he's doing something? Medium games. Large games. Okay. Okay, I can't do anything with him right now. That's fine. Let's make a new game. We'll make a medium game. And it'll be a horror game, because I haven't done one of those in a while. E for everyone. We'll call it Slender Main Support. Pick genre. So it's horror, and it needs to be horror action. On the... NES. And we'll use the FX engine. Okay. 2D graphics. Oh, I think I have to train myself before I can train him. Unlike someone, one person cannot effectively be responsible for every aspect. To a game, you need to make sure the best team has assigned which team. Okay. Pick team members whose skills match the area to get the best result. When you assign a team member responsibilities, you will see their workload. Try not to overwork them too much. Okay, well, he's really good with tech stuff. But not good with design. So, I'm perfect on both. I'll do the engine, and he can do story and quests. That would be tech, I guess, right? Okay. I think this is what I want. It's getting a little complicated now, I'll admit. Dialogue, level design, and artificial intelligence. Okay, he needs to be on artificial intelligence. Oh, fudge. Yeah, that's gonna work me over, isn't it? Okay, I need to hire somebody else. Vena gear. Okay, that's coming out. Oh god, this is gonna kill me. World design, graphics, and sound. I've obviously got to do that, and that. I wonder if I put Jorge on those two. Yeah, that's better. Ugh, my guys are burnt. I keep saying Jorge. I guess it's George. I don't know. It could be Jorge. It's a lot of bugs. Like, my guys are really getting... They're taking a beating for a game that I'm assuming is not even going to be that great. Oh, Jorge, you popped a bug in there at the last second. You son of a bitch. We gotta release it. Better user experience. Okay, I gotta hire somebody else real quick. Well, I gotta hire someone else, so we'll drop 100k on that, and we'll do game demo. Yeah, this better be at least decent. Oh god, it's not. Oh god, it's not. Okay, so it's gonna be like a medium. It's okay, it'll rake in some money, it's alright. My guys were completely overwhelmed trying to work on it by themselves. I shouldn't have done that to them. Alright. Joe Smodley. Alright, I need someone with design more than tech. Speed 113, 253. Oh, this guy's definitely the best. 18,000, 8,000, 20,000. Yeah, I'll go with this guy. He's expensive as fuck, but he's good. Joe Schmodley. Oh, he's famous, apparently. Alright, we need to make a new game. Actually, I guess I can make a new game engine real quick. Simple cutscenes, save game, game tutorials, mono sound. 180,000, that's nothing. Okay, so this would be the FX33 engine. Yeah, here we go. Boom, okay. Everybody work on it together. Here you go, knock it out. Our money is definitely going down, though. The G64 will be taken off the market. Oh, interesting. Okay, so I'm not putting anything on the G64 then. 100,000K game engine. Yeah. Alright, let's get a game made on it, huh? Actually, hang on. Let me look at something real quick. A publishing deal. 100,000 fans at least before you publish. Okay, well, I've got... Oh, I don't have that many fans. I've only got 2,900. So I gotta get at least a minimum score of 5 with those guys. 7 with those guys. And these guys are strictly for PC. These guys are any. Life, any genre, pirate, strategy, detective simulation, any topic, slash adventure. Let's go with these guys. Okay. Okay, okay. Medium game. Rated E for everyone. Let's do another pirate game. Oh, it's gotta be adventure. Okay. Let's try it on the Master V. And we'll use the FX-33 engine. So it's a pirate adventure. This will be Pirates of the Pancreas. How do you spell pancreas? Is that how you spell pancreas? This is just a Rick and Morty reference. Pirates. Not pirates. Yeah, okay, that's Axel Pancreas. That's what I thought. Alright. 2D graphics, yes please. Alright. Please don't be a flop. Oh, they're still tired. Crap. Oh dear. Tech. Yeah, I'm putting him on that. Oh, no, they're not still tired. Okay, that's just from earlier. Design and tech. He's pretty high on both. So we'll give him... He's pretty high on design, so I'll give him gameplay. And I'll do that. And we'll include all this stuff. Okay. It looks like they've got blue screens. Govador, the creator of the popular G64 pop game. Yep, okay. I'm glad I didn't keep making games for those guys. Let's see. I'm gonna put Schmodley on that. And... because his design is so high, and tech would be, yeah, okay, this is perfect. Right, let's go with that. I keep forgetting to change the sliders, though. Damn it. $351,000, yeah, not great. Okay, fine. Alright, so world design, graphics, and sound for pirate adventure game. World design should go up. Graphics should go up. Sound can go down. And there. Okay. Yeah, okay. No whammies, no whammies, no whammies. Come on. I can't afford another crap game. Come on, guys. Knock out them bugs. Alright. Better dialogues, 2D graphics, B3. Oh, I gotta research that. Oh, 3D graphics. Oh, I gotta get that. Hell yeah. You research that. Don't be a flop. Come on. Oh, I gotta get at least fives. Come on. No. Come on. I need a six. I need a six here. Yes! Okay, it averages out as a five. Okay, whew. Thank God. Could have been bad. I need a new topic. Virtual pet. Go ahead and research the crap out of it. Yeah, barely. All about design, technology. You're good. He can go on vacation. All right, we need to make a game. Pirate and strategy. Detective simulation. For PC. Let's try this. I gotta get a 7? Oh god, I don't know about that. Okay, we'll try it. It's gonna be another detective game, so we'll do... I don't know. Hang on. I'm gonna end the episode here, actually, because it's been long enough. And then I'll start a new one in a second. So, thanks for watching.